Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We are grateful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. We are truly grateful. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshiped. Father, we thank you. You are faithful. It's been 7 days.
Hallelujah.
Of praising you nonstop. Yet you deserve much more. So with our hands, once again, we appreciate you.
Hallelujah.
And with a shout of hallelujah, we reverence you.
Hallelujah. Woo.
Glory be to your holy name.
Hallelujah.
So proceed now to the crossover service, beginning with this communion. Father, let no one go back the same way, Lord.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. As a matter of fact, for everyone connected either in person or virtually, beginning from now, let our joy be full.
Amen.
In the year that is very close now, Father, please, let us go to bed in joy.
Amen.
And wake up in joy.
Amen.
It doesn't matter the dimension of joy we have experienced before. Let 2024 bring greater joy. In the name of Jesus. So we continue now, continue with us. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Now the Lord says, at least one, two, or three persons, that never again will you have an abandoned project.
Amen.
That in the coming year, what will normally take 1 year to accomplish, that you will enjoy divine speed.
Amen.
Such that it will not take any more than 1 month.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. We are really grateful. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshipped.
Amen.
And one more time, as you find a seat, let me hear you shout another loud hallelujah. God deserves a louder praise. Come on, give him a very, very big shout of hallelujah. God is so good to us. And I want to congratulate every one of us. If you don't mind, we have many of our brethren at the overflow. I went there to greet them just before we entered the last hour. Brethren at the overflow, I want to assure you that anywhere on this compound, God is here.
Amen.
Because for 7 straight days, we have been bringing down the glory of God. So I'm confident that even at the overflow, the Lord is there with you and is going to bless you like you have never witnessed before.
Amen.
And yet, we have many that have joined us virtually. And because God is not limited by space, I want to assure our virtual members that your blessings will be amazing in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As a matter of fact, a testimony came in. Somebody said the mother was in the hospital. And the mother on Thursday during the 1 to 2 hours of praise, had been scheduled for a surgery. But then she turned on the television in the hospital and was singing along. By the time the doctors came and they examined her, they canceled the surgery, that there's no need for surgery. Oh, okay, that's the testimony there. I hope you read as I follow. Amen. That's it. Say, my mom was admitted into the hospital on Tuesday from sickness, stayed up waiting to be checked by 4 a.m. But just Thursday and Friday morning, my mom was watching in my emergency room. God healed her. She was supposed to do surgery. Now God stopped a scheduled surgery. Come on, give the Lord a big hand. Now, I'm saying that to reassure the virtual members, the mother was in the sanctuary. And yet God reached her there. So wherever you are connected tonight, the Almighty God will reach you there. See, where you enter the new year is important. And I'm believing God that there is no better place than here tonight. So church, let me welcome the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days, the Rose of Sharon, the Lily of the Valley, Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Is that all you can give to him? Jehovah Shalom, our peace. Jehovah Shammah, the ever-present God. Come on, make him welcome because he's been here before we came. Hallelujah. Thank you. You may be seated. I'll be very, very brief because once we start like this, before you know it, we're in the new year. But I'm led to speak to us briefly before the communion. And this message is not a sermon. It's a message from the Almighty God. That for someone, from this moment onwards, the kind of blessing you will be receiving is called the much more blessing. Amen. I had only two good amen. Amen. So, the message for this communion is titled, The Much More Blessing. 2 Chronicles chapter 1, I will read verse 10 and verse 12. 2 Chronicles 1, verse 10. Give me now wisdom and knowledge, that I may go out and come in before these people. For who can judge this thy people that is so great? Verse 12. Wisdom and knowledge is granted unto thee, and I will give thee riches and wealth and honor, such as none of the kings have had that have been before thee, neither shall there any after thee have the like. Amen. Now Solomon was desperately in need of only one thing, wisdom and knowledge. But God, in response, gave him the much more blessing. Because God, in addition to wisdom and knowledge, and when I mentioned you say one, gave him riches. Can I hear you say one? Gave him wealth, can I hear two? Gave him honor, can I hear you say three? So for one request, Solomon got three blessings. I'm believing God for someone, because I've already claimed it earlier on, that for every one request I make to God, I will get three blessings in return. That will be the same for you in the name of Jesus. But you see, if somebody has some blessings, cars, houses, and money, but you don't have rest of mind, you are not really blessed. So God gave Solomon three for one request, but put icing on the cake and also gave him rest on every side. Because in 1 Kings chapter 5 and verse 4, 1 Kings 5 verse 4, say, but now the Lord my God had given me rest on every side, so that there is neither adversary nor evil occurrent. May that be your experience in this coming year. In the mighty name of Jesus. See, Solomon desired or developed a desire to serve God faithfully, and he developed love for the altar, that he approached the altar with a sincere heart and sacrificial heart, such as no one has done before.
And by the grace of God only, God looked at us when we don't even have what it takes and chose us to be the one that we praise him 7 straight days. And many people have said that there is never anywhere that has happened in the world. It is not us. When God wants to bless you so that nobody will be able to complain, he will set you up to do something that nobody has done. So if somebody is grumbling, say, why are you grumbling? We are determined to serve God faithfully as a church. Now, Solomon's progressive sacrifice and a lifestyle of continuous sacrifice, seeding and service, brought him much more blessing, with rest on every side to enjoy the blessings. Solomon in 2 Chronicles 1 verse 6, 2 Chronicles 1 verse 6, Solomon went up to the bronze altar before the Lord in the tent of meeting and offered 1,000 burnt offerings. That was the first time anybody had ever done that. By the time you get to 2 Chronicles 7 verse 5, 2 Chronicles 7 verse 5, King Solomon offered a sacrifice of 22,000 cattle. Now he has moved from 1,000 burnt offering to 22,000 cattle and 120,000 sheep and goats. And so the king and all the people dedicated the temple. By the grace of God, this long worship began in 2014 with 72 hours of praise. And God, I was here at the time, that night, like this. And God said, is that all you can do? So in 2015, I told the brethren that we'll do 100 hours. And we did 100 hours in 2015. So I thought 100 is perfect number. So in 2016, we did 100 hours again. And then God said, you have tarried on 100 for too long. Is that all you can do? Then in 2017, it's okay. You know, Solomon did 120,000 sheep. So let's do 120 hours. Then in 2018, and I said, brethren, we'll be adding 1 hour every year. So in 2018, we did 121 hours. And but God was going somewhere with us. And I don't have all the time to tell you, but they are all documented. If you have not had it before, I'm sure one of these days you will come across how we arrived at 168. But in 2019 was the season one of 168 Hours of Praise. It was meant to be a slip of the tongue by one of our brothers. We were reviewing 2018, and he said, in 2019, when we are going to be doing 170 Hours of Praise, people shouted, what are you talking? And I heard the Lord said, see how all of you shouted. So for all the things I've done for you, 170 hours is too much for me. And as I was going home, the Spirit of God continued to bother me. Now, did you hear what I said? So for the first time, I did the math. What is this 170? Then he called to me that we have a song we sing. 247, I will praise you for... I said, wait a minute. 24 times 7. Oh, that's 168. So why is 170 that this brother is saying? Oh, I say, well, we need 2 hours to cross to the new year. But still, I just kept quiet. I mean, who do you tell that you are? I said, go and sing, yo. But the Lord insisted. So by January, I had not responded. By February, it came very aggressively. Are you saying you didn't hear that I want you to praise me this long? When I had no peace again, I told my wife. My wife said, the devil can't ask you to praise him that long. If it's the Lord, then let's obey. And I told the music director, the choir director, they agree with me. It was like a weight was lifted. And once we announced like that in February, for the first time in our 23 years of marriage, my wife became pregnant.
I mean, he was a massive one.
So,
of course, Isaac's birthday, you know by now, 1st of November.
So, 24th of December 2019 was when we then had season one, doing the testimony night. And since that time, it's been season 2, 3, 4, and now it's 5. If you are clapping for the Lord, give him a really big clap of praise.
I've taken time to share all of that with you because God is yet going somewhere with us.
See, God can be very reciprocal in his dealings with us, especially when it has to do with him blessing us. Don't let anybody deceive you. Nothing goes for nothing. He told Solomon, nobody has done what you have done, and I'm going to do for you what I've never done for anybody. God is reciprocal. James 4:8. The A part says, draw near to God and he will draw near to you. That's law of reciprocal. In 2024, the Lord is asking for more. And when he shared it with me, I was a little bit surprised because, I mean, what can you do after 247? I had him. He said, in 2024, moving on, you are going to give me, he called it 168 plus. He said, 247 plus. And I didn't understand that at the beginning. And then he spoke to me in the language that I understand. He said, have you heard of YouTube Plus? I say, yes. He said, have you heard about ESPN Plus? I say, yes. If you are watching YouTube, that is not Plus. Every 3 minutes, you get advertisement. They cut you. I joined with Night Service in Nigeria, and Daddy was saying something very important. An advertisement came. I said, what kind of thing is this? And let me hear what Daddy is saying. God is saying that YouTube is the baseline, but YouTube Plus has features that basic YouTube doesn't have. ESPN is baseline, but ESPN Plus has features that ESPN doesn't have. And when I was sharing with the ministers, oh, they told me there's even Disney Plus. So God is asking for 168 plus. So this program from 2024 is not just, it's no longer just 168 hours, it's 168 plus. Can I hear your amen? And so we began to trust him for the plus. So the very first thing that is very clear is that it is 168 hours plus 3 hours. Now, don't call it 171 hours. Because we'll start at 7 p.m., 24th of December. We'll finish at 7 p.m., 31st of December. That's 168 hours. Now, 7 to 8 is plus 1. 8 to 9 is plus 2. 9 to 10 is plus 3. Now, inside each of those hours, God is looking for some things we've not done. Like sharing testimony, for example, for 1 hour of what he has done. Giving people opportunity to give their life to Jesus Christ, for example. And there is 1 hour that is called Holy Ghost Hour. Now, the Holy Ghost Hour will be hour where there will be every incurable disease will be healed. Let me hear you say plus, 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 plus. So there will be other plus, plus, plus. Inside the 168, there will be no messing around. You either praising God or get out. Be serious time of serious praise. No jesting. Because now it's plus. Quality feature. No YouTube interruption. God is no longer going to take just basic 168. It's going to have 168 plus. Can I hear somebody clap for Jesus? The 3 hours, he called it more than music. So the 7 to 8, 8 to 9, 9 to 10 is called more than music. If you want to clap, go ahead and clap. So the logo, he told me, this time I won't let you wait in February, because I don't know whether you will change your mind. Say tonight, tell the people tonight, and launch the logo for next year. I don't know if media has the logo. In surrendering our lives to Him. 2, approaching the altar with sacrifice of prayers, like 7 by 7. Sacrifice of praise, like 24/7. Our services to Him, like people cooking around the clock, feeding people through the 7 days. Like people cleaning the bathroom all minute, all hour long. Like cleaning the sanctuary, make sure everywhere is not messed up. Can you help me appreciate those who serve the Lord? The media team were behind the camera, changing the hours, changing the song, changing. Come on, let's give the Lord a big hand. The choristers, everyone that served God. That's the token of our covenant. But it does not end without a seed. When you have done everything like this that you have done, a true child of God who understands seed time and harvest time must put a seed to the altar. So tonight, just before we share the communion element, I want to remind us that Solomon sowed a seed of 1,000 burnt offering, followed by 22,000 burnt offering, and then 120,000 burnt offering. Seed sowing is an expression of our trust in God and our love for God. Progressive and sacrificial seed provokes God's blessing. So tonight, if you have not given your life to Jesus Christ, He doesn't need your money before your soul. He needs you to first give your life to Him. Surrender to Him under this atmosphere. And then begin to serve Him. Then your seed makes sense. For those of us who are saved, I should not be teaching you about seed. We've praised Him for 1 straight hour of praise. We've done the dancing. We've done the singing. For somebody, $1 could be like 1 million. Because that's all this fellow has left. For someone, $10,000 a month could be chicken or something. You won't even know that money has left your account. Your seed is not in what you have given. Your seed is in what is left after you have given. So, I challenge you therefore, if you are not saved yet, wherever you are, just raise your hand up, because it's dangerous to partake of Holy Communion if you are not a child of God. It's a meal for believers. So if you are not born again and you want to give your life to Christ, please raise your hand so I can see it. I won't even call you out, because there are ushers and protocol around. They will just give you a paper to write your name. But if you don't do so, please don't take the communion, because it will be a very dangerous thing to do. It is commanded that communion is taken by believers and believers alone. Now, I want us to bow down our heads, because we are ready. My Father and my God, I thank you so very much. I'm praying, Lord God Almighty, for everybody under the sound of my voice that needs to give their life to Jesus. Please have mercy on them. Please save their souls. Let this message challenge them unto submission to your Lordship. And for every one of us, let the communion of tonight take us to heights we never thought possible. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Let your amen be a resounding amen. Amen. Tell somebody it is 168 plus. By the way, I must tell you, and God told me this one, and I believe it's not only me, that even you as an individual in the coming year, I will not accept basic service. Everything you give to me in the coming year must be plus. Can I just say plus? I need the choristers back now. Glory be to God. In our CCG, when they will serve you bread first, you eat the bread, but we keep the wine, because all of us, we take together. Because we have a large crowd, just sit down where you are. All our ministers, you know, we move around very quickly so, and serve so that he can go very quickly. I will break the bread from here, and then they will begin to serve us. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. In the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah. Owo Oluwa nbe lori aye mi o o nbe mi fo o nbe mi sare owo Oluwa nbe lori aye mi o nbe mi fo o nbe mi sare owo Oluwa nbe lori aye mi o nbe mi fo o nbe mi sare
Wonderful. Glory be to God. Thank you.
I wish we could hear from the overflow. I believe if we are done here, they must be ready to. Let me have you shout one loud hallelujah. Please partake of this communion by faith. We'll take one prayer point afterwards. I believe the Lord will answer the prayers very quickly in the name of Jesus. Amen. And after then, we'll sit down and then we'll take some music ministration. While that is going on, then we'll give our seed. If you want to do electronic way, media will show us how to give electronically. If you want to write check or cash, then the ushers will give envelope, and then during the music ministration we'll give our offerings. After the same manner also he took the cup when he had supped, saying, "This cup is the new testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." In the name of God the Father,
amen,
and of the Son,
amen,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now just drop the cup and lift your hands to heaven. Just worship him for a minute. Karabo sheketelebo raketalaba yendere mororobo shakalaba. Mendere mariandalama sheketelebo randalama yakashendere mororobo katalaba. Mendere mariandalama kosha keterebo rendere mariandalaba yakatelebo. Thank you, my Father. Ephesians 3:20. The Bible says, "Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us." Brethren, Solomon asked for one thing. God gave him three and gave him rest to enjoy the blessing. I want to pray with everything that you have in you and say, "My Father, my Father." Say loud and clear, say, "My Father, my Father, give me the much more blessing for every of my requests. Please grant me three other blessings and give me rest on every side." Pray that prayer. Pray it very seriously. Please pray it. Give me the much more blessing for every of my requests. Please grant me three other blessings. And let me have rest to enjoy it. Me rest of mind to enjoy it. Give me rest of mind to enjoy it. Please, let me join hand with your neighbor and pray for that neighbor and say, "My Father, my Father, I pray for my neighbor for every of his requests. Grant him three more blessings and let him enjoy rest on every side." Now go ahead and pray for that person seriously. "My Lord and my God, I pray for my brethren for every request. Let there be three additional blessings on top of you granting the request. And Lord, let there be rest to enjoy it on every side. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed." As we have prayed, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. For every one request we make, the Lord will give three additional blessings. And will give us rest on every side to enjoy the blessing. As you sow the seed after this one state hours of praise, may you enjoy a hundredfold of blessing in the name of Jesus. Your seed will speak favor in your direction. Your seed will open doors unto you in the name of Jesus. And the Lord will bless your seed in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Now give the Lord a big, big round of applause. And then you may be seated. Before I take my seat for a while, I always make sure that I don't hold tight of a year into the new year. And sometimes people don't remember that. It's not a law. It's just something that I've done for a long time. So if you are like me, if there is a tithe that you are yet to pay, I will recommend that you do so before we cross to the new year. Who is sure that 2024 will be full of multiple blessings for you? Say another loud amen.
Praise the Lord. We thank God for all he had done for us at the 168 hours of praise. It is God. If we say men, we'll just be deceiving ourselves. If it had not been God that helped us. But we want to thank the Lord and appreciate those people that the Lord has used to be part of the 168 hours. And we start with the choir. Let's appreciate them. Let's appreciate them. It is not easy to stay here and hold microphone even for 1 hour. Some of us, we adopted choir. It's not easy. But some of them, they have been here from the beginning and they are here now. They show up when the singers don't show up. Let's appreciate the choir. The band, wonderful people. Wonderful. The backups, all the choir, we say thank you on behalf of everyone, on behalf of our pastor and the congregation, we say thank you. Then we go to the powerful media. There are times that we are not here, but we watch online. Those people are there 24/7 as well. Let's appreciate the choir, the camera, the engineer. For those of us that come to church, especially in the morning, there's a lot of behind the scenes that we don't see. Let's say thank you on behalf of every one of us, our pastor, and each every one of us. We say thank you to the media. Then the protocol. Let's appreciate that. They pick up guests 4 a.m., drop guests 2 a.m., make sure everything is right with the guests. Guests are here on time. Let's thank God on behalf. We appreciate you. Protocol, God bless you. Hospitality. 24/7 food. You know, if you don't have food, you may not have strength to dance. But these people are there 24/7 giving us jollof rice, chicken, and some Nigerian fufu. Let's appreciate them. And everyone that supported hospitality, we say thank you. The cooks, we say thank you. Some of them served 18 hours straight. I saw it with my eyes. They were there, making sure things are done well. We say thank you to them. Then the ushers, let's appreciate them. They are the ones that direct us to where we sit. And they are the ones that tell us that even if we want to sit, our purses cannot have seats. Amen? Even if we want our purses to have seats. Let's say thank you to all the ushers. We appreciate you. The health department, wonderful people. Somebody has headache, they are there. Somebody falls, they are there. Let's say thank you to the health department. We appreciate each and every one of you. The security, we say thank you. Those that direct traffic, it's not easy. Like today now, thank God for the Alpha Road. Pastor is going to talk about that. Some people can exit from behind the field. You don't have to come through the church anymore. Let's say thank you to the security department and the sanitation. Wonderful people. Men of great calibers helping us clean the toilets. Some of us, we drink water, we leave the bottle. They pick it for us. They clean after us. The Lord will clean up all the debts in their lives and all our lives in Jesus' name. And some people are in general services. There is general. They general volunteers. Let's clap for ourselves to general volunteers. the general services, and also the prayer department. If I don't remember any department. Social is part of the media, but let's give them a round of applause. The social media, those that are posting the thing for us on the Facebook, Instagram, let's appreciate them. There's a particular sister in Canada, I don't know if she sleeps at all. She's always on YouTube commenting. Every minute, I wonder, is this sister sleeping at all? Let's appreciate them. And also, if we have forgotten, you are in general services. So don't be offended towards the new year that they didn't call you. So all of us remaining, we are in what? General. Let's appreciate those in general services. Amen. God bless you. Let's have the media project the video. God bless us all. Amen.
Isn't God good? We are in 2024 already, and we will be the first to welcome you to this new year, 2024. So with joy and gladness and excitement, we welcome you to the year 2024. This year is a leap year, and straight away, let me say to you that in this new year, we will leap for joy. We go to bed in joy, we're going to wake up in joy. There'll be no sorrow of any type anywhere around us in the name of Jesus Christ. 2023 was awesome. I'm believing God that 2024 will even be more awesome, greater, more glorious in the name of Jesus. RCCC, the King's Palace at 5371 East 5th Street, Katy, Texas, is one of the many, many parishes of RCCG all over the world. We thank God that has kept us for these many years. By the grace of God, the church was planted on April 23rd, 2006. So April 23rd, 2024, we will turn 18 good years. God has been so, so good to us. Our anchor word, our theme for the year of 2024 is multiply. Multiply. We will multiply on every side. Our anchor scriptures is from Genesis chapter 9 and in verse 7. Genesis 9 verse 7, the Bible says, "As for you, be fruitful and multiply." And the Bible says, "Bring forth abundantly in the earth and multiply in it." I'm believing the Almighty God that you will multiply on every side in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Before we continue, I would like to remind some of us and tell many of us who may not be aware that our vision statement at the King's Palace says, transforming the nations, we are world changers. And we are living up to that vision statement. I therefore welcome you into 2024 to join us as we transform the nations around us and we begin to change the world. We hand over to my brethren who will take us through all that we need to know about 2024 as far as all our programs and activities will be concerned in 2024. You need to be aware right from the beginning so that you can plug yourself into all the blessings that God has reserved for us. I pray for you one more time. Amen. That you will multiply. Amen. Abundantly. Amen. All of us, we live in 2024. Amen. In joy. Amen. In peace. Amen. In abundance. Amen. In fruitfulness. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. There shall be no limitations at all. Amen. Which means everywhere we turn, we are breaking forth. Amen. We are breaking through. Amen. We are multiplying. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Welcome again to 2024.
God bless you. Now, our mission statement is very clear and precise, spelt with an acronym, WEST. With W, we welcome all. E, we empower all by the word and by the spirit of God. S, we send all out to win souls. And T, allowing the Lord to transform all. Our values are driven by the statement spelled lofty, just like it sounds, L-O-F-T-Y, which translates to, we L, share the love of Christ, through several O's, outreaches, and F, fellowship, with teachings and training founded on why Yada, which of course, as you know, means praise. Our vision is crystal clear because our church is created to raise end-time world transformers, Christians who are not just seasonal, but operational in the various offices of ministry. That is why we're driven by our vision statement, transforming the nations, we are world changers. We are pretty confident that as many as may be listening to this broadcast at this moment are welcome to be part of what God is doing here at the King's Palace. Now, we therefore would like to provide you with some more important engagement information.
Join any of our services physically or virtually. Our first service takes place from 8:30 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. Our Arise morning talk show takes place from 9:30 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here in the TKP studios. Our second service takes place from 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Our midweek Bible study, also known as Digging Deep, is every Tuesday from 7 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. Your Sunday service is not complete without attending the Sunday school. You can join our Sunday school every Sunday as we search for treasures in God's Word. Sunday school takes place at 4 p.m. Central Standard Time through Zoom, and the meeting ID is 837-0217-3450. And the passcode is VSCHOOL, all uppercase. Get your children from toddler to grade 6 engaged with our children's church services every Sunday. First service starts at 8:30 a.m. Therefore, check-in time is from 8:20 a.m. to 8:45 a.m. Second service starts at 10 a.m. So check-in for Children's Church is from 9:30 a.m. to 10:20 a.m. You can pre-check your children in for Sunday second service only. To do so, please text their last and first name to 346-520-0346 between 1 p.m. and 9 p.m. on the Saturday night before the Sunday you intend to meet. Join the teenagers, grades 7 to 12, at the U Church for their hybrid service, either physically or virtually, every Sunday at 10 a.m. For the virtual engagement, you can join through Zoom. The young adults, college students, and singles, LIFT, Live in Fellowship and Truth, have weekly Bible study every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. Central Standard Time at the Pavilion. You are welcome to join our daily early morning prayer from 6:30 a.m. to 7 a.m. via Zoom. The Zoom ID is 836-1861-4896, and the passcode is TKP. Join our Midnight Cry, an hour of intercession until revival breaks loose upon us. This is every day at 12 a.m. Central Standard Time. The Zoom ID is 572-692-7821. To share your testimonies, you can text the number 713-780-6890 or call 281-391-RCCG or send an email to info@rccgthekingspalace.org. For prayers or counseling, please call the church office at 281-391-7224 to schedule an appointment. For family celebrations such as children's dedications, naming ceremonies, weddings, and any other family celebration, please call the church office at 281-391-7224 or Pastor Ronti Awana at 713-828-8487. Would you like to serve? You can connect with our ministries and departmental leaders via our website, RCCG TKP app, and you can pick the directory flyer from the information desk at the foyer or send an email to info@rccgthekingspalace.org. Are you a nursing mother? We have a nursing room upstairs where you can comfortably feed your babies and still stay connected to our Sunday service. For help, please ask an usher. Are you in need of interpretation? For our grandparents who need interpretations, we have our interpretation service available during service. Kindly ask any of the ushers for information when you come.
You are a member of the King's Palace as soon as you decide to be a member. Soon after, you just need to attend our new Member Connect banquet scheduled on the average every other month for an onboarding session and interaction. The first new Member Connect for 2024 is scheduled for Sunday, January 7th at 12 noon at the TKP Pavilion. For our preparation, please use the QR code on the screen to RSVP or ask for an RSVP card from any of the ushers. At the King's Palace, we all grow together into the image of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. All workers and intending workers are expected to join the growth class once a month. The notice is sent at the beginning of every month to the church members' WhatsApp group chat. For your regular updates of services, programs, and events, download the TKP Church app from the Android Play Store or the iPhone App Store using RCCGTKP or text APP to 832-307-0800. Join our WhatsApp or Telegram group for real-time updates by sending an SMS from your cell phone number to 281-624-7051. Please subscribe to all our social media platforms. Look us up on YouTube at King's Palace TV, Facebook at kings.palace.35, Instagram at RCCG The King's Palace, and lastly, on Twitter at King's Palace TV. It is recommended that as many as are yet to be water baptized by immersion or those who didn't fully comprehend what it meant at the time they did it should enroll in baptismal class by calling or texting 346-543-1188. The following events are the lineup of events for 2024. For our outreach events, we have our monthly power conferences. This is a monthly encounter with God, featuring our Shiloh Hour, Power Night, Revival Hour, Breakthrough Night, and Night of Encounter. It is held during the last weekend of every month. Please refer to the church social media platforms for updates. The January Power Conference is scheduled for the last 7 days, starting January 25th to January 31st. Our 18th anniversary features the Four to Crown Talent Hunt, Praise Night, Mega Outreaches, Inner House Sports, Parades, and many more activities. This will be from April 21st to the 28th. The Four to Crown Season 5 Talent Hunt begins with the preliminary stages in April and final stages in July, featuring music, drama, creative arts, film, and academic competitions. Children Vacation and Retreats kicks off with the Children and Youth Spring Break Retreat at Camp Choye on March 10th to the 14th. The cruise to the Bahamas and through Miami runs from July 15th to the 19th. For more information, call 832-338-7460. Food distribution is held on a weekly basis every Friday and the last Saturday of every month. Also, the food pantry is open for service on call. For more information, call 281-391-7224. Influencers Weekend will be held from February 24th to the 25th. Transformers Weekend will be held from April 13th to the 14th. Interested in foreign missions? The 2024 foreign mission trip will be taking place from June 19th to the 22nd. For more information, speak to Deacon Jide Afolabi, and you can contact him at 832-421-7842. Vacation Bible School is from June 24th to the 26th. This event is completely free. There is no reason for your child to miss it. Get your children enrolled as early as possible. Mission Week will be from May 25th to the 27th. Join our variety mission engagements and empowerment events featuring Season 4 of the Global Mission Summit. Psalm 150 Season 5 will be held on July 13th, 2024. This is an annual outdoor outreach music performance of the TKP Music Academy, showcasing the students' talent through the orchestra and other performances. Jubilee Week takes place from July 1st to July 7th, 2024, featuring a virtual members' Jubilee Week celebration. Dream Big Conference includes a theatrical stage drama ministration and African Children Mission Outreach Challenge. There will also be an Independence Day celebration, a pulpit and pew generational interchange, and the Inner House Annual Film Festival. Youth Week will be taking place from July 12th to the 14th. Come and connect with the teenagers. Lift Sunday Takeover and College Connect will be held from July 20th to the 21st. Our Back to School Backpack Distribution for 2024 will be from July 27th. If you would like to donate or sponsor backpacks, call 281-391-7224. This year's Children's Week will be held on August 13th, 16th, and 18th, featuring a movie animation challenge, variety night, sports, and back to school anointing. For the TKP Drama and Film Academy, enrollment starts in January 2024. Women's Week starts on September 17th and continues on the 20th to the 24th, featuring the yearly special women banquet themed A Night with the King. Men's Week will be held on October 18th to the 20th. Join the TKP's Men of Valor for the best of family fun engagement ever. Our Family Connect Conference will be from October 25th to October 27th, 2024. Children's Hallelujah Night on October 31st is a pure, fun, and godly way to engage the children on Halloween night. The Gala Night is a workers and members appreciation night. Our Christmas toy distribution will be on December 21st, 2024. 7 hours of night vigil for 7 days, also known as 7x7, will be from December 14th to the 20th. Finally, to crown the year, our 168 hours of praise will be from December 24th to the 31st.
As Pastor pointed out earlier, this year, 2024, is loaded with blessings for us at the Redeemed Christian Church of God, the King's Palace. There shall be no limitations. So expect to enlarge, increase, flourish, and multiply on every side. We shall experience all-encompassing peace, all-around fruitfulness, divine encounters, divine interventions, miracles, signs, and wonders in the name of Jesus. The Lord Almighty shall multiply everything that concerns you, that concerns me, that concerns your household, that concerns my household in this year 2024 of multiplication in Jesus' name. Welcome again to year 2024.
Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. It will be the year like never before.
Amen.
You will live for joy, amen. And everywhere around us will be celebration.
Amen.
Welcome to 2024.
God bless you.
Amen.
And have a wonderful, wonderful new year.
Amen, amen. Thank you.